All right. Hello, everyone. Welcome to today's webinar. Before we get started, just a couple of those normal items to take care of. We will have time for questions at the end of the presentation. You can type those in by clicking the Q&A section in that lower portion of your control panel, or you can use the chat as well to chat with each other. We will be posting a recording of the webinar on our blog. The link for that will be shown at the end. And if you would like a PDF copy of the presentation, there will be a link to download that on that same post as the recording. If your question does not get answered today, or if you think of any other ones, please email our support inbox, which will be shown at the end as well. Okay, what's on the agenda for today? Exercise can create a strong reaction in people, right? Some people love it, some people really do not love it. My goal today is to give all of you, those that love exercise, those that don't, or those that just don't exercise because they just can't get themselves started, some ideas and options to either start a routine, make your daily exercise routines a bit more fun, and just freshen it up a bit. I'm going to give you a quick overview and reminder of why you should care to exercise at all, and then we'll talk about the daily exercise routines and some other ways to add some extra movement that also adds some fun into your life. So let's get to it. Like I said, I want to first quickly touch on why you should exercise in the first place. I know a lot of you know that exercise has benefits, right? But I just want to review them as a reminder of why you do need to make it a priority in your life. Exercise strengthens our muscles. We know that, right? And that includes your heart muscle. Your heart is like any other muscle in your body. We have to put stress on it so that it adapts and gets stronger. Similar to strength training, exercise helps to keep your arteries clear as well with cardio or strength training. It helps increase HDL, which is our good cholesterol, and it helps lower our LDL, which is our bad cholesterol. Exercise can help manage and even prevent chronic conditions, things like heart disease, high blood pressure, type 2 diabetes, stroke, arthritis, and cancer could possibly be prevented or at the very least managed better with exercise. One of the ways it does this is that it reduces inflammation in our bodies, which is the cause of many health issues. So lowering this is huge when it comes to management and prevention. Chronic pain is another condition that can be caused by different things, but exercise, specifically low impact exercises like swimming, can help strengthen muscles and can help that pain. And it also helps with weight loss, which can reduce some of that pain as well, as we know, when it comes to chronic pain. Next benefit is bone health. Strength training and cardio put stress on our muscles, and our muscles adapt by building themselves back up stronger. Our bones are the same way. When they're stressed through exercise, they increase in density and are less susceptible to osteoporosis, which is low bone density, which can lead to more frequent bone breaks. We know strength training increases our muscle mass, which I already mentioned once. Muscle mass naturally decreases as we get older, but we can help slow down and reverse this trend with regular exercise. Sleep. To save some time, I'm going to keep it simple. Quality and duration of sleep can both be impacted positively with exercise. And we know that sleep sets the tone for our entire day, right? And nobody likes getting sick. Aerobic exercise and strength training helps activate our immune system and can help leave you less susceptible to colds and flu. Any type of exercise can help improve our mood, including reducing anxiety and depression and brain health overall. We release specific hormones that help mood when we exercise. Exercise can help promote memory, reasoning, judgment, and thinking skills. According to the Alzheimer's Research and Prevention Foundation, regular exercise can reduce your risk of developing Alzheimer's by up to 50%. Also, it can slow further deterioration in those that have already started to develop problems. That's a big deal. Exercise that is specifically geared towards stretching increases your range of motion and your flexibility, and having good range of motion and flexibility can slow the degeneration of your joints. And if you've had an injury that has prevented you from moving certain joints for a bit, these exercises become even more important to regain that movement to be able to do simple tasks in your day, right? Stretching also helps reduce your risk of injury. If your muscles aren't used to stretching and then you all of a sudden try to do a movement that stretches it, what's going to happen? We're probably going to pull a muscle, might tear a muscle. It's not going to feel good. Stretching also helps relieve aches and pains from exercises and normal activities, daily activities as well. It can help improve our posture, specifically stretching the muscles of the low back, the shoulders, the hamstrings can help keep your back in better alignment. And we know good posture helps that lower back pain as well, right? So it's a very positive domino effect if we start stretching regularly. And then of course, balance exercises are very important as well and help tremendously as we get older, especially to help prevent falls, right? So I wanted to do that because I just wanted you to get a picture that there are many, many, many reasons to exercise. So let's get to some actual ideas for the rest of our time today. Now, some of you have probably heard these many times before, but maybe you haven't tried or maybe tried once or twice and kind of gave it up. And hopefully there'll be some ideas today that you haven't thought of and you'll think, hey, I can try that. It's all about trying different things, right? So first, my first tip is getting a friend involved. You like your friends, right? You like hanging out with them. So ask if they want to get active with you. Now, this can help not only with the fun level of our workout, but it can also help with accountability. If you don't feel like heading out for a walk and you're going to do it alone, it's pretty easy just to say, I'll skip it for today, right? But if you know you're meeting your friend on the corner for that walk, or you're going to be talking to him on the phone while you walk, you're not going to leave them hanging, right? Less likely anyways, I hope. And if you know you're going to get to chat with them and hear that funny story they've been waiting to tell you, that's going to keep that positivity surrounding the actual activity of the walk up too. Even if the workout itself isn't what you'd consider fun, having a friend with you can make a little less not fun. Having someone else groan next to you when you're trying to hold that plank during a YouTube workout and then laugh at yourselves and engage those core muscles even more is great. Again, just adding that positivity surrounding exercise in whatever way you can. This tip can also mean finding a group on social media and discussing your workouts, helping to keep you accountable with your exercise routine, and then just getting advice from others on new classes they tried and liked or new workouts, things like that. There's lots of ways to connect, even if we're not in the same place as people. And don't forget, a friend can mean a four-legged friend as well. A walk is typically more fun with your pet or dog usually. I say usually because for some pets, it's more of a drag than a walk, right? But hey, you're still getting moving. Next better option is join a class. Again, this is not only to create more fun in your workouts and that social aspect of it, but it keeps up the accountability as well if you're paying for it and if you know others will notice if you're not there. But let's focus on that fun part more. There are a ton of classes out there for every type of activity you can think of. There's Zumba that's been along for a while or around for a while, or any type of dance classes, spin classes where you're on a bike, boot camp classes where they do all sorts of different things, water aerobics, kickboxing. It's endless, really. There's a class called Pound that's inspired by drumming. Again, anything you can think of, there's probably a class around it. And if you don't want to or not able to go in person, if you're in a small town or they don't have that available, many of these types of classes are available online. So you can do it from your living room. But again, the goal here is to find something different, something that makes you smile while you're doing it, hopefully. And the instructors in a lot of these classes are extremely effective at creating a fun and energetic and motivating atmosphere too. So that's the benefit of having a class and having someone else leading. You get that motivation. And again, hopefully it ups that fun level. And then speaking of online, YouTube itself offers thousands of exercise videos that are completely free. You have to be mindful of your limits as these videos don't know any health limitations you have, of course, but you can modify as needed and find some really, really fun workouts. Again, different. And not only you can find, so on that same note, not only can you find fun workouts, but you can find that variety that we're looking for that can help keep those exercise routines fresh. Whether you can't get yourself started with an exercise routine, or maybe you're in one, but you're kind of in a rut, right? You're getting bored. Adding in some variety is a great way to inject some joy into your workouts. Like I mentioned, try a new type of workout. This not only can help you enjoy the workouts more because it's fresh and new, but you'll most likely use different muscles with a new workout, which is really important because you don't want to miss any muscle groups when you're exercising. So if you add a variety of different workout types, different lengths, different intensities, it helps your body continue to adapt and improve. And it helps keep your mind from getting bored and focusing on that time as well. On that note, keeping yourself from focusing on that time by means of distraction is a great way to make your workout seem less daunting, because you're not only focusing on the hard work you're putting in, you're focusing on something else, right? Distraction from your workout can come from many different places thanks to technology. If you're simply doing some stretches, some bodyweight exercises, or workouts that are not, you're not watching a video, watch some TV while you work out. You can put on a funny show or one that you're really into while you burn those calories without even thinking about it. This is a great exercise tip in general as well. Try to do something while you watch TV. For a lot of us, watching TV is a large chunk of time during the day that you're not doing anything. So adding in some movement can be an easy way to not have to change your whole routine necessarily. You're just adding in another element to something you're already doing. So walking in place, doing some bodyweight exercises, doing some work with some resistance bands or some hand weights. Adding in movement during a time that you're doing something you enjoy but are normally sedentary makes it really easy to improve your health. Other things you can do, like I already mentioned, is watching a show, listening to music, listening to a podcast, listening to an audiobook, which is my personal favorite, or FaceTiming or calling someone while you're out on that walk or hike or on the treadmill. Again, it's about adding something to those workouts that can not only help distract you and make the time pass quicker, but it can make you actually look forward to those activities. Let's say you make a rule that you can only listen to that book or watch that specific Netflix show while you work out. Is that gonna make you give it more of a priority? I bet it does if you stick to the rule, right? If you make it more priority, get on that treadmill. If you know you get to watch that one episode that you've been waiting for, it's probably gonna work to get you on there, right? Give yourself a reason to want to work out. And one option for that is to tie it to another entertaining activity. On a similar kind of note to this, another way to add fun to your workouts can be by adding a new piece of home equipment to the mix, if it's in your budget, of course. Treadmills and exercise bikes now almost all have options with an internet connection with video screens. You can choose already recorded workouts, or you can join live classes. I talked about how energetic and awesome those online teachers are already, and the ones on these machines are obviously no different. I bought a treadmill back at the beginning of 2020, and I can tell you it's one of the best purchases I've ever made. I'm not a huge cardio fan, but I've gotten more into it lately, and part of it is because of this machine. And the reason I like it the most is because I don't even have to control the speed or intensity of my workout. The videos do it for me. The machine is controlled by the video. I just finished a workout program last week that had me running on the beaches of Costa Rica, right? Talk about adding some fun to it and some distraction. The trainer gives you facts about the country, the wildlife. You got to see beautiful waterfalls. And if the workout's too hard, you can slow yourself down. You can modify the workouts and it adjusts for the rest of the time. You can also choose workouts based on your fitness level and length. It's really easy to find a good match for you. And like I said, it's not only treadmills. You're probably familiar with the commercials with the spin bikes like Peloton and those types of equipment as well. If you have a machine, but it's older or it doesn't have that new technology, you can still set your phone or tablet up in front of you and watch a video of the beach too, right? We do what we can. Now, again, I know you may not have the budget for this right now, but something just to keep in mind. You can also find some good secondhand machines around too. Just keep your eyes peeled for that type of thing. All right, let's talk about another way technology can help make exercise more fun. Tracking. Now, hang with me here. I know if you've been on the webinars, some people don't like tracking, but when we add the element of tracking to our workouts, we can see our progress, right? And it can help motivate us to keep going. If you see you got 5,000 average steps last week per day, challenge yourself to get 5,500 on average this week. Make it a gain. It can be really rewarding and enjoyable to look back at all that you've accomplished. And having an app keep track of those things for you is extremely helpful as well, right? We have the Health Check app, of course, available for free. And of course, there's many other apps and smartwatches and things out there that can keep track for you. You can challenge your family and friends to competition. There are lots of ways to add this element into your exercise to help keep it fun. And then rewarding yourself for hitting milestones and goals can be a really powerful way to keep you motivated and add that new level of appreciation for your workouts and daily activities as well, right? This can be as simple as a virtual badge that some apps will give you for hitting a certain lifetime steps or miles or certain number of workouts. You can buy yourself a new shirt, exercise outfit, new headphones, new pair of shoes after you hit a certain number of workouts or a certain average, things like that. Internal or intrinsic motivation is ultimately the key to being happy with our exercise routine, right? But external rewards, external motivations can help you along the way. There's absolutely no doubt about that. So, and again, it can add that happiness, fun, enjoyable factor as well. All right, next tips to make exercise fun, play some games. You don't have to just get on the treadmill or do sit-ups or go for a walk to have it count as exercise. Any movement counts, right? And some of these games will get your heart rate up more than that walk and you'll have way more fun doing it, right? I put just a handful of options for you to get those wheels turning in your head to find some things to do. So think about it, run it back to your playground days, tag, capture the flag, Red Rover. Just hearing those names puts a smile on my face. I hope it does to you as well. Think of your favorite recess game, make a play date with some friends or your own kids. Now you might have to modify it a bit, of course. We don't wanna be clotheslining our kids during a game of Red Rover, but have some fun. Or have your kids teach you a new game that they play in gym or recess. I know there's lots of new games out there that my kids are telling me about all the time. Or make up a new game. If you can stop taking exercise so seriously, you might just enjoy it a little more too, right? Sports is another great option to put some fun into your exercise. Join a local volleyball, basketball, slow pitch softball, kickboard, shuffleboard, curling, running club, anything. Again, similar to that exercise class, adding that social aspect can help make it fun and also help keep you accountable to be consistent in going each week, right? If you don't have any leagues or sports that you like or the schedule doesn't work, you can make one up for yourself too and invite people to join you. It doesn't have to be a structured league where you pay or anything like that. You can just say, hey, every Tuesday night, I'm going to go play soccer at the park. Come on over. Keep it casual. Again, have some fun. That's the point here, right? Let's get our technology back into the discussion with game playing as well. You have apps like Pokemon Go that can help get you off the couch, catch those little guys around your town. Now, with this one, be mindful of traffic, as I know in its heyday when Pokemon Go was very popular, caused some accidents because pedestrians weren't really paying attention to where they were walking. So be careful with that. But other ways, you can get yourself a virtual headset and do some VR virtual reality exercise. I know the new headsets now have actual exercise programs and workouts, or you can do games like they have Beat Saber and where you slice and dice your way through different fun songs. You can keep it old school. Grab that Wii console again and do some bowling or baseball with your little Wii people. Again, if you move while you do it and it makes you happy, go for it, right? Another way to smile during exercise, have yourself a dance party. Put on some of your favorite songs with a good beat or some of those old middle school or high school dance songs you used to jump around aimlessly to. Get that groove on. I bet you'll work up a sweat in 5 minutes with some of those songs you come up with, right? Now I just said stop taking exercise so seriously a minute ago, and now I say don't take yourself too seriously either. Very few of us look good when we dance. Let's just get that over with right now. So embrace it. Let yourself go. You're going to get bonus points for the extra ab exercises you're getting, again, by laughing at yourself or your friends or your family members. Some other ways to enjoy exercise a bit more is to use nature to your advantage. I know for some of us right now, it's still a little bit cold, but it's getting there. But getting outside has huge brain health benefits along with the physical benefits of actual exercise. There are a ton of great ways to get active outside, right? I already talked about this. You can walk your dog, you can go hiking, you can go skiing, you can add sledding in the winter, you can play sports, which we already talked about, frisbee golf, regular golf. All of those things are great ways to add that, again, social aspect that I talked about once already. But again, with that nature, getting out, getting that fresh air as well. Has anyone ever heard of geocaching as well? Basically, it's like a giant treasure hunt all over the world. It's fantastic. There's different little treasures hidden out in nature, literally all over the world. There's usually a little logbook that you can sign your name into when you find it, and you can trade a little knickknack for one that someone else left. Go to geocaching.com and it shows you how to sign up and get started with spots that are close to you. Highly, highly recommend that. All right, a few more minutes here. Let's end it with some other ways to get in exercise kind of outside of those daily activities. One is sign yourself up for an event. Do a 5K walk run for a local charity. Do an obstacle course race with your friends. Spartan Race or Tough Mudder, I know, are two of the more popular ones. Do one with a friend and have a blast. It's not about time. It's not about going fast. It's just about getting active. And then on the other side, having a specific event to prepare for can also help in that day-to-day exercise by keeping your workouts on your radar, because you know you have that end goal in mind with whatever event it might be. If you already exercise and are in a good routine and you're happy, signing up for an event can help push it to that next level. Maybe you already do some 5Ks. Maybe you look at a 10K or a half marathon or eventually even a full marathon. There's so many options out there. And again, a lot of them have specific charities that they're raising money for. So you're doing good at the same time. And then add exercise to your vacations. Now, I know some of you are thinking, that's the last thing I want to do on my vacation, right? Yes, you need rest and relaxation for sure, but see if you can add in some movement when you can. For example, I took my kids out to Utah on vacation and we visited a ton of cool places that we had to hike to get to. That picture here is actually of me and my son looking tiny, I'm very short anyways, but looking even more tiny under the Delicate Arch in Arches National Park. We had to hike over an hour to get there, but it was absolutely worth it. It's like we've talked about, distracting yourself is a great way to exercise without even knowing it. But it's not only hiking. You can go to the mountains and ski. You can go to the beach and swim or walk on the beach. Sand workouts are actually really good, and do other activities that are available. If you're treating yourself to a vacation at a spa, take a yoga class. Again, it doesn't have to be high intensity. Stretching, those types of things are super valuable for our health as well. Or go out to dance if you like the nightlife. Even water and theme parks include a ton of walking themselves, right? Finding excuses to get up and move, even when we're on vacation, is going to be beneficial for you in so many ways. All right, that's it for the content for today, but I just want to summarize with a couple of things, right? We need to add movement to our lives. It's essential to our health and our happiness, but you can have fun and get healthy at the same time. You just need to find what works for you. So get out there, try some new things and go for it. All right, we'll get to some questions here if anyone has any, but here are the upcoming webinars for the next couple months. April already that we're talking about financial fitness, just some small tips and things that you can do to help save some pennies. And then May, we're going to talk about some brain health, some mental health, right? It's okay not to be okay. So we'll talk about some different tips and then make sure you know your resources that you have that you can help. And then if you do have lifestyle rewards for your points for watching the webinar and you're doing questions for those lifestyle awards. Again, some people have to, some people do not, but if you do, here are the questions. Not too difficult for this month, I don't believe. And these will be on the slides too. So if you don't have time to jot them down, they'll be on the recording, of course, and then on the slides. So you can download those within the next day or so. And then of course we have our contact information. We're on all the social media, our blog, that's where you're going to watch this recording or any other recordings. That's where you can sign up for future webinars. And then, of course, if you want to just contact us and chat with a health coach, give us a call, shoot us an email with any questions that you have on health and wellness.